Hey guys, it's Becky with Design Bundles, and I am here to talk to you today about layering heat transfer vinyl. Now, if you've been intimidated about layering before, maybe you tried layering adhesive vinyl and it didn't work, I am here to tell you that layering heat transfer vinyl is so much easier than it seems, okay? So there's no reason to put it off any longer. We're gonna tackle a project today, and hopefully it will inspire you guys to jump right in. So let's go ahead and hop over to Cricut and we will get started.
So here we go in Cricut Design Space. Now I've already imported the image, but what I wanted to show you is that in order to layer, you do want to identify all of the different layers that you're working with. Most of the time your designer will have grouped the layers together, so that really works for you. And unless we're going to resize this, you are safe to go ahead and move the different layers apart. That is not a problem at all. Now I'm going to undo that because we do want to go ahead and size it. Now this is only sized to be 5 inches wide, and I want this to be sized to be 8 inches wide. Now all I did was select my entire design, type in 8, and Cricut Design Space will take care of the rest. So now what I can do, I want to, if I can, try to keep all like pieces together. So for example, these white pieces, I can move those off to the side. Those are the only white pieces. Same with the black pieces. Now see, the black eyes are separate from the mouth. So I'm holding down my shift key and I can select multiple pieces at once, and I can go ahead and group those together. You also want to pay attention to what you need to group and what you need to weld or attach. So definitely for the eyes and the mouth, I will attach those. And the same for the eyes, those are already attached or welded, so those are fine. The brown piece, this is the only brown piece on there. Now this is a light pink, okay, and it looks like it has already been welded or attached. We can go ahead and, oh, see, that's what I did not want. I do not want to move that blue piece. So if I can send that to the back and get it out of the way. Now I can move this pink piece and I can move the darker blue piece. Okay, now you may be asking, why did I destroy that entire design to get those together? Well, first and foremost, I wanted to get these light colors separated. Now I changed these just a bit. I changed the original design just a bit. I added different words. So that just means that they were not grouped from the designer. Now that's on me. So, but it's important to know how to isolate light colors. And that's exactly what we did. So I'm going to get these together and I'm simply going to attach them. Now I'm doing that because in Cricut Design Space, if I don't attach them, then the software itself is going to separate those into different areas on the cutting mat. Now I don't want that to happen because it makes it harder to layer, in my opinion, okay? So these have been attached. Everything else is already attached or welded or grouped in the order that we wanted them to be. So now I can just click over to make it, and you will see that Cricut Design Space has broke up each individual color, including that one. Okay, and we can proceed to cut these individually. Now I am working with scrap pieces, so I only want to point that out to say that you do want to make sure that you're paying attention to the grid, so that you know when you put your piece of HTV on your mat that it's going to match up to where your design is cutting. So, and also you want to make sure that you go in here and mirror these because we are working with heat transfer vinyl. They're all mirrored, so now I can choose continue. Now your material setting is going to depend on the brand and type of material that you have. The brand that I'm using, I will use the Everyday Iron-On, but I need to switch my pressure to more. So I'm not saying that you need to do that. If you're unsure, make sure that you do a test cut first. Just test cut something small and make sure that your cut settings are correct before you jump on in. But I know that this works for me, so I'm going to go ahead and cut these, and then I will reconvene with you in our work area so that we can go over some tips and tricks on how to put this together. All right, guys, so these are the scraps of heat transfer vinyl that I'm using. Some are larger than others, but like I said, I just checked on my mat to make sure that all of these are going to be large enough for our design, and we'll take it from there. I'm going to go ahead and get these on the mat and get all the pieces cut out, and then we'll take a look at putting it together. We do have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if you need a test of your layering skills, 7 should do the trick, and feel free to grab that file and join me. Alrighty, so I have cut everything, and this is what I'm looking at. I have all 7 pieces, white, black, tan, the mint, or I used teal, navy blue, pink, and light pink. Now, what I wanted to show you while we're looking at all this goodness is, first of all, I did exactly what I told you guys not to do. This is a different brand, and I didn't catch it. And because I didn't do a test cut, it cut all the way through. Now, I lucked out that this is a brand that, or this was a shape that it doesn't make a difference. I can still layer with it, but I just wanted you to see, that we're not all immune. So, in terms of spacing, okay, this is the largest part of your design. And what I like to do is to go ahead and line up the various pieces together, because what you're going to do is use this to determine the spacing on your garment, or in this case, we're using a drawstring bag. So I want to, let's go ahead and talk about this file. We're talking about layering, and we're doing 2 types of layering, not just one. So we are doing layering actually on top of other heat transfer vinyl. And then we're also doing layering as in just a multicolor design. So for example, if we were not layering sprinkles on top of our donut, then we wouldn't have to worry about something called shrinkage. Okay, but shrinkage, when you're layering things on top of each other, or when you have something like this that needs to line up perfectly, then shrinkage is what happens when you start heating up your heat transfer vinyl. And we'll talk about it more, but what it means is that we need to do just little short kiss presses. So we'll do like 1 or 2 seconds, just enough to peel off the carrier sheet. So what that means is we need to think in terms of what layers we're gonna put the vinyl down also, because the sprinkles need to go on top of the donut. Okay, so I'm saying all that to say I'm putting the donut on the bottom, the donut shape on the bottom. That way, whenever it's time to start removing the layers, my donut will be on the bottom. Okay, I promise this makes a whole lot more sense. We're gonna get to it. But I put the donut on there, and I put the brown part of the donut down here, and then this part will be up to you. And you know what? I always recommend pulling up a copy of the file. So do not feel like you are restricted. Go ahead and pull up a copy of that file, and that will certainly help you with your placing. Now with sprinkles, you can, just kind of wing it, but just make sure that all of your sprinkles end up on your donut. Now this is not going to be an exact placement. We are not going to layer all this and press right now. Okay, we're trying to just get an idea of where everything is going to fit on here, and that will make it easier when we need to start pressing the design. Okay, so what do you guys think about that? I think it's pretty cute. Let me go ahead and I'm gonna switch this mat out with a pressing mat and grab the easy press, and we will get to pressing this right away. Okay, so this is my drawstring bag, right? It's just a regular 100% cotton drawstring bag. And I do want to still treat it like I would a shirt. I'm going to fold it in half all the way down and give myself that middle crease. Okay, that's going to help us with our alignment, and it also counts as our pre-press. All right, now pre-presses are important because it gets any excess moisture out of the fabric, and it just helps you to get an overall better press for your heat transfer vinyl project. So we don't have to do it super long. I'm just going to do it about 6, 7, 8 seconds. There we go. Now, this is a drawstring bag, which means that part of the bottom is going to be taken up whenever it's full. All right, so I just want to keep that in mind so that when I'm lining up my design, I'm going to line it up down the middle and also on the top part. Okay, so here we go. So that is where I want my design. It keeps the bottom free so that when it gussets out, I don't lose the bottom part of my design. And the same thing, if I tie it up at the top, I shouldn't lose too much of my design either. So with that in place, sorry, the easy press wanted some attention. With that in place, I'm going to peel off these top two layers, holding down my bottom two. Okay, now I'm still not going to press these together, but I want to make sure that one of them, at least one of them, stays in place, and I'm going to start with my pink donut right here. All right, so what I can do now, usually I would say, oh, let's cover with our Teflon sheet. Because we're just going to do these quick little presses, that's not absolutely necessary. We do have the carrier sheet here on top of our HTV, and that does protect it. So we will bring our Teflon sheet in at the end when we're doing the one big press, okay? So I'm just going to pull it over. Now this is timed for 320. Okay, so see, I only press that for a couple seconds. This should be a hot peel. I didn't leave myself very much room here. There we go. Okay, layer one of seven is done. So with that in place, let's line up the bottom part of our donut. There we go. Also, I should have addressed this before, but I did not. When you're working with layering, you do need to research what types of HTV can be layered and what types cannot. And what I mean by that is not every type of heat transfer vinyl can be layered, especially when you're using smooth and glitter heat transfer vinyl, and then certain types of holographic and that sort of thing. They don't all layer well, and especially like putting things on top of glitter, that's usually where you run into the problem. So you can put smooth on top of smooth, you can put glitter on top of smooth, but you don't want to start layering things on top of glitter. There are some videos floating around that say you can layer on top of glitter, and I have layered glitter HTV on top of other glitter HTV, but typically speaking, you want to knock out those designs if possible. So now for pressing this one, I am going to cover it with my Teflon, but I'm still only going to press 1, 2, 3. Okay. Also, these short presses also keep you from over pressing or overheating your vinyl. There we go. All right. So next is time for, we're going to go ahead and do this teal layer. So I can take off the other top pieces, but I'm going to go ahead and leave them layered. There we go. Again, I don't have to use the Teflon right now. I know that gets confusing. If you're ever confused about to use or not use Teflon, just go ahead and use it. So it seems like we're doing good here. All right, but I do have a few spots where I had the same overcut problem. So I'm just going to try to be gentle as I peel these off. I don't want to accidentally mess up my heat transfer vinyl. I think I got a good stick. So when this happens to me, all it means is that I will go back at the end and make sure that any missing pieces of the carrier sheet are taken care of. It doesn't mess up anything with my vinyl because it's still all on there. It just makes it a pain when getting it all off. You can either just use your fingernails or you can get a pair of tweezers. You pick at the sides a little bit. They should come off pretty easy. Okay, so finally that layer is taken care of. We can proceed to one of our other layers. See, my eyeballs did not want to stay on there, but I line this back up. So this is what I like to do. I like to line it back up and then just peel off the top pieces. And if I continue to do that, eventually I won't have any more layers to line up, and that will mean that all of our layers are taken care of. So once again, I have exposed heat transfer vinyl. So we'll cover that up, give it a quick couple second press. There we go. It is all much easier from here, guys. Make sure you smooth it out every time. You don't want to make a mistake of letting the design or the fabric sneak up on you. Matter of fact, we can layer these two colors at the same time. Let me point something out real quick. I want you guys to pay attention to this part. I can layer these at the same time because my design does not overlap. Okay, my eye is down here, sprinkles up here, and you have to watch where these carrier sheets start getting close to the other parts of the design, because if they overlap or come underneath your HTV will adhere to the carrier sheet and not your project. So we definitely don't want to do that. On this one, I'm safe, so we'll cover it back up. Press it for a couple seconds. There we go. Now all we have left are the eyes. Okay, so all of our pieces are adhered on there. Now technically I could have put the eyes down, pressed for the full 15 seconds and been done, but sometimes when you're overlapping these small pieces of carrier sheet, you will get these little pressing lines. So if you just go ahead and get everything tacked down where it's supposed to be, and you can just come back with your Teflon sheet with no carrier sheets, none whatsoever, and just make sure you get quite a bit of pressure. Sometimes it's hard to judge with the easy press. And you want to do for the full 15 or 20 seconds, depending on the manufacturer of your heat transfer vinyl. And there we go. That is our finished project. And we have layered all these pieces. They all look absolutely perfect. And I don't have any issues with my design being not centered or any of the pieces not being aligned, because we aligned all those up in the beginning. On top of that, because we didn't press each layer for the full 15 seconds, we don't have to worry that these bottom layers have been overpressed. So overall, this is a great design. It's a great project to work on some layering with, and it just turned out really good. So let's go ahead and recap.
So how do you guys feel about layering heat transfer vinyl? I think it is super duper easy. Just pay a little bit of small attention to details when you're lining things up. Pay attention to what order you're layering things in, and make sure you're not layering things that don't need to be layered. So when in doubt, make sure you check with the manufacturer of your HTV, because they will tell you if it can or cannot be layered. So don't forget that. And, you know, of course, if you have any questions or comments about the process that we use, make sure that you leave them below in the comment area, because we always come back in and check with you guys. So I really appreciate you watching today, and make sure you subscribe to the channel, because we always have great projects for you right around the corner. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.